sound of bagpipes filled the Immaculata Hall Saturday evening as the community of Fort St. John came together to toast Robert Burns.
The wisest man the world ever saw, he dearly loved the lasses. To the lasses.
Lighthearted jokes from the head table were made while drinking Athelbros and enjoying a traditional haggis dinner with all the fixings. Hosted by the Knights of Columbus and Fort St. John Masonic Lodge, celebrated its 51st year of bringing the community together to pay tribute to the Scottish poet. But that history was fueled by a conflict half a century ago, back when the community was a much smaller place.
The story that I have, and that I think is the most common one, is that there was a bit of conflict between the two clubs back in the day, 51 years ago. And of course, you know, Fort St. John was a lot smaller. And there was a bit of rivalry to the point of, well, let's just leave it with rivalry. There was quite the rivalry between the two organizations, and it got a little out of hand.
Davies says he recalls the conflict grew to the point that the two clubs were given a court order to come together and do something positive for the community.
So almost like two little kids having a little fight, you know, you're going to work together and do something. And that is actually what came about, the organizations coming together and doing this event for the good of the community, doing this event, you know, for the broader good of everybody.
And now, 51 years later, the two organizations have developed a strong friendship through hosting the traditional evening focused around Burns' legacy. The poet and songwriter died over 220 years ago at the age of 37, but he is still remembered throughout the world today. One of his most well-known poems, "Auld Lang Syne," is sung by millions to ring in the new year.
Auld Lang Syne, we'll take a cup, oh kindness yet for all.
Like Burns' poems, the evening revolves around the belief that all lads and lasses stand together in a brotherhood of man. Brendan Miller, CJDC-TV News, Fort St. John.